14. It can be found in your pew Bible on page 612. For this is what the Sovereign Lord says, I myself will search for my sheep and look after them, as a shepherd looks after his scattered flock when he is with them. So will I look after my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places where they were scattered on a day of clouds and darkness. I will bring them out from the nations and gather them from the countries, and I will bring them into their own land. I will pasture them on the mountains of Israel, in the ravines and in all the settlements in the land. I will tend them in good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel will be their grazing land. There they will lie down in good grazing land, and there they will feed in a rich pasture on the mountains of Israel. I myself will tend my sheep and have them lie down, declares the Sovereign Lord. I will search for the lost and bring back the strays. I will bind up the injured and strengthen the weak, but the sleek and the strong I will destroy. I will shepherd the flock with justice. Let us read responsibly Psalm 80, verses 1 through 7. Give ear, O shepherd of Israel, you who lead Joseph like a flock, you who are enthroned upon the cherubim, shine forth. Restore us, O God. Let your face shine, that we may be saved.
O Lord God of hosts, how long have you been angry with your prayers?
You have fed them with the bread of tears, and give them tears to drink in full measure. Restore us, O God of hosts. Let your face shine, that we may be saved. Our second lesson is found in the 10th chapter of Hebrews, verses 11 through 18, and in your pew Bible on page 851. Day after day, every priest stands and performs his religious duties. Again and again, he offers the same sacrifices, which can never take away sins. But when this priest had offered for all time one sacrifice for sins, he sat down at the right hand of God. And since that time, he waits for his enemies to be made his footstool. For by one sacrifice, he has made perfect forever those who are being made holy. The Holy Spirit also testifies to us about this. First, he says, this is a covenant I will make them after that time, says the Lord. I will put my laws in their hearts, and I will write them on their minds. And then he adds, their sins and lawless acts I will remember no more. And where those have been forgiven, sacrifice for sin is no longer necessary.
Tonight's gospel will come to us from the second chapter of Luke, verses 8 through 15. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and singing, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So we come to the third candle. Nice job lighting it tonight. The third candle is the shepherd candle, right? So as we move through the preparation story, right, we have prophecy and then Bethlehem. And then the shepherd's candle, right? The announcement of the angel that comes to the shepherds who are just out doing their everyday lives. And the angel comes and gives them, to these ordinary people, the announcement that Jesus has been born. And so with this shepherd's candle, the third candle, it's also a rose candle. We have two rose times during the church year, the third week of Advent and the fourth week of Lent. In the ancient church, both Advent and Lent were meant to be kind of preparatory times, were meant to be times of rededication and self-examination and repentance and a return to discipleship. And then in the middle, they had Rose Sundays. And that was kind of this moment to take a break from all of this, the hard work of self-reflection and self-examination, and to just take a breath, to be joyful. And so in the middle of Advent and in the middle of Lent, we get these Rose Sundays. So this shepherd's candle, this rose candle, reminds us of how even we, ordinary people, get the announcements that God has for us. That in the midst of our daily lives, wherever our lives may be, God will send messengers into our midst to give us the words that we need to hear, to show us the paths that we need to see, to be provided with the direction that we need to know. Right? So the shepherds stand as an example for us. As we've been through the readings this evening, we hear these stories of shepherds in the Old Testament, in the Psalms, and even throughout the New Testament. So much so that one of the great images that we have of Jesus is being that of the Good Shepherd, right? This child who's born in a lowly manger then becomes the shepherd to us all. Right? This normal activity becomes one of the most familiar images of Jesus that we have. And so in this third candle, the shepherd's candle, we who might take that shepherd's place, realize we are united with Christ in the same way. That Christ takes on our human nature, takes on our human existence. God comes in human form to fully understand who we are. And as we are shepherds to this world, Christ comes to be the good shepherd, to give us the example, to be like one of us, so that God may fully know and understand the human condition. So God comes into this world in the form of a child as a gift, right? For unto you is born, right, a Savior, the Messiah. Right? And so with the lighting of this candle, as we as